Hello guys, Shrimp Time here, and today we got another video about selective breeding of our shrimps. In today's video I will show you how to get the first step to achieve boa and snowflakes, red boa and red snowflake shrimps. So guys, at the beginning I would like to apologize you for the poor video quality, because unfortunately I am not able to make the nice video edition when I'm doing something at the same time. So I hope that I will manage to create this video so that you will see the patterns I'm interested in. And now let's go to our main topic. So I must say that I'm not interesting in the fact if I'm getting the females or males at this time. I will make the decision later when the shrimps will be a bit bigger. And what I'm looking for? I'm looking for nice fishbone pattern, nice spider legs, nice spots on the tail, and nice spots on the head. So this is the first stage of getting those shrimps, so there will be some more stages. So let's start. This is the first shrimp that I pick for my selective breeding. As you can see, we got nice pigmentation on legs and we got a very thick back tail pattern, and we got some spots on the head, and those valors are quite important for me, because I know that I will have to make another selection after I get young shrimps from this pack that I'm picking up. So I know that after this selection I will need to make at least two more tanks so that we can go for the galaxy snowflakes and for the boas. And this is the step that will make it easier for me to make that selection. This is another shrimp, quite nice back pattern, but lovely head spots. And those head spots decided that I picked the shrimp up. And also the spider legs are quite important. You can see that we don't have the full fishbone on the back, but this is the thing that I will work on the next stage. I think that if we would get a full fishbone, we could name this shrimp a boa shrimp. So when you're doing this type of selection, you can go in two different ways. One way is to pick at least two or three females and one male with the best pattern you can achieve from the tank. For example, from 200-300 of shrimps, you will get those shrimps with the best pattern, and try to breed them for the next generation and repeat that. The second way that you can go, if your tank number is limited, you can go for some factors, some appearance in the shrimp that you want to duplicate, and afterwards make this decision. So you will get another pack of 200 to 500 shrimps after a half of year, and from that pack you will make the further selection, getting a bit better patterns than we got in this tank. So we will have the better possibility to get better shrimps for the initial stage of making the boa pattern and the snowflakes pattern strong. I use this way because I have a limited number of tanks. I got only something about 50 tanks, and this is way not enough to get the best patterns from the shrimps, especially if you are trying to get some different lines, for example red, black, galaxies, fancies, etc. If I would get those 50 tanks only for galaxies, I think that I would be able to make this selection process a bit shorter. But when I'm limited with the tank's number, I need to this little shortcut or this little cheating way of getting the shrimps I want to get. You can see also my tank so that you can see the shrimps are that are left and the parents of the shrimps that I'm picking up. And now we got another shrimp with very nice back pattern with a little error in the fishbone line. But we got also nice spots and we also got those spider legs. So this shrimp can be very productive in getting better and better pattern. And we want to pick the best shrimps with the pattern we are looking for. So this is an example what we can achieve from a Galaxy and Galaxy fishbone pack. And in this way of selective breeding, you are able to make every of your pack better. But you need to be very selective. You need to be very restrict. So I advise to sit down, write down some decisions, some patterns you are looking for, some patterns that are excluding those shrimps from getting to your next selective tank, and this will make the process much easier, because if you do not have enough discipline to make those decisions, you can look at shrimp, check your checklist, and then decide. And you need to be restrict. No possibility to get away from that list, because if you won't follow that restriction, you will get a bit backwards on your work. So another shrimp, the shrimp has lovely spider legs, very nice fishbone pattern, a good coloration with no lackings in the pigmentation, and she got a little of spots under the tail, which is very nice, addition for our genetics in our next tank. Also, you need to be familiar with the fact that most of the shrimps that you will get from this type of selecting breedings, like 80%, will be culls. And those shrimps won't meet the criteria you have decided to make the next selection. Because I know that in the next selection, I want to get shrimps that will have the boas phenotype and that will have snowflakes phenotypes. And each shrimp that won't meet those restrictions will be culled out or won't be taken under the consideration in the next breeding stage. So now we'll have another shrimp that I have decided to pick up. And here is our beautiful shrimp with great fishbone, but the shrimp also get those spots under the tail. And in my rules, I want to take only shrimps with enough number of spots on the head, because I don't want to go backwards. Because if we'll get a shrimp with very nice patterns on the legs, on the back, etc., and our shrimps won't get enough of spots on the head, even if we will achieve those other factors like spider legs, like thick backline, we won't get the nice gradation due to the lack of the spots on the head. And please don't push your decorations in our tank. So we got another shrimp, and this shrimp is very near to the shrimps I want to use to breed boas in the next stage. We don't have the great head pattern because we don't got those round spots, but we got enough of number of spots and we got a very thick back layer. So the shrimp has a very good potential if it will crossbreed with the shrimps with enough number of spots or with the oval spots on the head, we'll be able to achieve very, very nice next generation. And you need to remember as well, if we will mix those genetics, each of young shrimps will get a little of genes in the next generation that we are interested in. And this will make some things easier, because if you like the boas that got also spots on the lower side of the tail, you will get the shrimps with genetics from this selection that I make. And this is our last shrimp, a very nice fishbone pattern, quite okay head spots, and the most important thing, nice tail spots underneath. So these are shrimps that I selected. I also will cool out and maybe add some shrimps in future if some shrimps in this pack will get older, when the shrimps will get older in the separate tank. So this is all. I hope that you like this video. Please leave me a comment if you do, and write me if you want more and more of videos in this type. Thank you.